Yes, the stream is live now. Yes,
I'm glad
we are now live. That was great, dude. That is great. We did 20 minutes of just behind. Just that was awesome. Now we are live.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, man, Pete asked if we're streaming now or soon.
Yeah, like we're live right now.
Yeah.
Now it all makes sense. The world makes sense all of a sudden. There we go. We were just sitting in the background thinking we were streaming.
Yeah.
You know, he laid me in control, dude. I'll drive us right into the wall over and over and over again. What do you want from me?
Good time. Well, I did it once, too. I think we even went longer that time I did it, though. We went for like about 30 minutes. We're like, where is everybody?
Yeah, dude. What the hell is going on?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, it was great. And we were talking about all sorts of horrible shit. So it was like a second where I was like, oh, my God, should we have said that?
Yeah, really.
Yeah, that was good. Maybe that was a good thing.
Yeah, maybe that was good that we missed out on the whole thing.
Yeah, right, there we go. So how are you doing tonight?
We got to retread everything.
Yeah, everything is coming up. It's hot. Oh, yeah. How hot is it? Fuck that shit.
How hot is it?
Yeah, how hot is it? There it is.
I should have had one ready for that.
Yeah.
Yeah, it says EJB says clearly we missed 20 minutes of pure gold.
Oh, you know. You know.
Not really.
How dare you? It was. Dude, I was laying it out.
Yeah. Well, we were talking. Yeah.
Go ahead. Do it.
We were just about ready to go see what Mark Hoffman was selling on eBay.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We were. We were going to look because Mike has another Death Dealer painting up, man. And dang, I'm glad I didn't share. I would have been sharing my screen just to you, man. That would have been horrible. Give me a second here. Let me pull this out. All right.
Wonder if he's got anybody griping at him about like selling the Death Dealer stuff or, you know, characters or whatever, like they used to. They used to really rag on him a lot, you know. But
there it is. Bam. There's the painting.
Let me see. Oh, that's pretty cool.
Oh, I like it.
I like that girl up in the, like all blue like that in the mist or whatever. That's cool. Or if she's like in the smoke. I'm not quite sure what's going on.
Sky Goddess. It says Death Dealer Sky Goddess.
Nice.
Fucking working her witchy ways on Death Dealer. And yeah, he's like stabbing this dude in the chest. That's right. That's what women will make you do right there.
That's for sure.
There you go. Now, what else? He had another one, too. Let's see what else he had. It was Batman, I think. Batman. There you go. Going for it.
How much Batman. Is Batman? Oh, wow. He's a full-on painting.
Yeah. Let's see if that's 130. Man, oh, jump on this, man. Right there, people. Mike Hoffman doing Batman. Taking the big stuff. Bam. Got a little smoke going.
Going into the fan art world.
Yeah.
Well, did you watch his last video?
Mm-mm.
I did watch that. It's about taking credit.
There it is.
And how we shouldn't do it.
How we shouldn't take credit for nothing.
Well, he says like the Aboriginal people, like, you know, don't take credit. And I don't remember why that's better than the way we do it. But, you know, he had some reason there. Forgot.
Damn, I'm taking credit for everything. Get out of the way, Mike. I'm just kidding. Yeah, there we go. That was the paintings. They were beautiful.
Yeah, they're looking good. I wonder like how he feels about like painting again. Is he like good with it? Is he doing it because he has to, or what's going on with that? You know. Remember that guy, Sean Patty, I think his name was?
No.
He did kind of like all these muscly barbarian type comics. I mean, this was like long before me and you were hanging out. But he was kind of in that world of like Mike Hoffman a little bit and eBay. And then he started selling, you know, like kind of like hardcore porn barbarian pictures and stuff.
Hell yeah. Now we're getting somewhere.
And
he
would put them up, and he would like have like, you know, like he would always have like all these derogatory remarks about him, about how this is gas money, this doesn't matter, you know what I mean, stuff like that. And so I would always comment, you know, just to be supportive. His wife also died too. That was another reason why I always felt like I should comment. And then one day he just like went off on me about how he thought that I understood, like I was enlightened, that this stuff was crap, and like how dare I be, you know, saying hey, good job on, you know, this stuff and all that. And I just was like, God, you know, I don't know. I guess everybody has a bad day. I didn't know what to say to that, so I just like left it at that.
I left it and rode that off into the sunset. I got you.
Yeah.
Well, off we go there.
I don't know if he still does it or not, but you know, everybody's got to like kind of justify that stuff. I notice, you know, it sells and makes money, but then like, there's just certain people that have to like, you know, just always act like it's crap or, you know, things like that. I don't know. It's like, oh, well, if I could just do my, you know, if I could do my, like my perfect work or something, then, you know, then everything would be matter and like the world would be perfect. But I have to like draw like porn, you know, so I'm
not supposed to do it. Don't have to. There's a choice in there, isn't there?
Yeah. You don't have to do nothing, really. It's like a choice you're making.
Trust me, right? Trust me. You ain't got to do nothing. Take it from me. Take it from old Gib. We ain't got to do shit.
Nope.
This is where my wife raises out of bed like Dracula and slaps me in the back of the head.
What the hell? Work. Do some work, you lazy bum.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love you too, honey.
Yeah.
Drawn sword graphics in the chat. Yo,
yeah, I saw that. Hey, man.
Guess I could be clicking on these. There we go. Now, well, I realize I'm in the driver's seat. Sometime I forget.
Yeah. Yeah. So if you guys don't like the show, it's Jibrin's fault.
Please. My fault, dude. You know, it's always has been. I'm a has been. Yeah. Always has been. All right. Yay. But I started actually working on the Indiegogo page.
Oh, nice. That's
where things are getting scary. Because now it's like I'm at this point where it's like create the product. And I'm like, oh.
That's great. I love it, man.
So, nervous. I'm going to do it, you know.
Heck yeah. You got to do it. You got to hustle up because I'm going to do it eventually too. And you got to get out of my way.
Yeah. I'm going to trip up, dude. I'm going to trip up. No, this goes.
No. It's going to be awesome. This is going to be like the highest one yet, I think.
We'll see what happens.
Well, I just thought of some new thing too. What? God, I wish I would have wrote that down. It was like something to go on Indiegogo, and I completely forgot what it was.
Something going on Indiegogo?
Well, yeah, it was like an extra because, you know, you got the book and you got the art, and it was like, what else do you put? We always like kind of struggle with that. And I was like, oh, that's a great idea. And now I completely forgot what it was.
Damn, forever. So was it? You think he thought of the key to Indiegogo? Sitting on the shitter earlier and didn't write it the fuck down, Jeff. Damn you.
I was driving, but yeah.
So you need a little notepad.
I know. But I remember, like, the other thing I was thinking was, like, a little print set. Because, like, all my art is small. I was thinking I could either do, like, you remember how they used to do the portfolios with, like, an envelope? And then they'd have, like, five or six plates inside it?
Mm-hmm.
Which I always liked those a lot. Or I could do... I could just do prints, like on, you know, like with a board and a plastic bag, like I do, like when I sell prints. I think both of those would be good. But the portfolio idea might kind of be neat, because then you get a little extra art, you know. But there was something else. Yeah, dang it. I wish I'd have remembered that.
because that's the thing right now. It's just trying to get, like, think about, like, the product and what else. What else, man?
Yeah.
And right now, and I'm also just, like, adding more because I want to, like, bring up the page count. So, I'm trying to add some more to it. I mean, I have stuff drawn, you know, like, throw some extra drawings and stuff in there.
Yeah.
You know, stuff like that.
Got to get that thing out so that, like, you know, you'll have some stuff left for number two.
Yeah, I mean, well, it's stuff that I already have, though. Like, basically, ready to go. And stuff that I was like, I'm just going to do as much as I can, like, while it's running.
Yeah.
Trying to, you know, finish up the book. I want to go ahead and get another one, pick, like, buy another proof copy. You know, change a couple of things.
That's cool.
A couple of, what is it? The, I don't know, there's a margin on a couple of the pages, you know, I want to, like, try to fix.
Yeah.
I'm a little unhappy with, see if I can fix some of that stuff and get some of this other stuff in there. And then be, you know, move on. Yeah, definitely, though, dude. I'm ready.
Yeah.
You know how it is. And it's also, it's just all the stuff that I did a lot of stuff last year, you know.
Yeah,
I'll put it in this book.
Definitely.
Especially since it's not just like a Doom Barbarian book; it's a bunch of stuff already. So,
yeah,
just gonna add it. I had like a at one point I had done a Valentine like thing, and I might just add it into the book. You know what I'm saying? Because I had done it for the book and just and took it out at one point in time. So I'm like, man, I might as well just print it into like a page on the book.
That's right. It's Valentine's somewhere. It's Valentine's Day somewhere in the world, right?
Yeah, you know. It's not really, it's kind of horrible anyway, so, you know.
Yeah.
It's like threatening.
I bought this book a long time ago. What was that artist's name? I can't remember. And it was kind of like a bunch of jokes about, you know, being married and stuff. So it was like, I remember one of them was like, you know, marriage is the only relationship where there's like two slaves and no master.
No.
And then it had like, you know, the drawings along with that. And that's kind of like it. You know, it's not Valentine's Day, but it's sort of like sarcastic love humor, whatever the hell that would be.
Yeah. Peter says, Peter's dropping some Conan knowledge here. Did you hear they are bringing back Savage Sword of Conan to be published by Titan Black and White magazine?
Nope, didn't hear that.
Are they doing, is it just going to be the old ones? Are they just rerunning them? Or are they going to make new ones?
I hope that, yeah, is new. That would be nice. But it kind of sucks because, you know, it's like, I don't know. Who can afford to work for anybody anymore? So it's like it kind of gets me excited, but then I think like, who cares, I guess.
Are you going to do it, Jeff? Did she get you to do it?
I'd love to do it, but then I wouldn't want to do it because I'm sure it pays like shit. And especially if it's an indie company, it's probably free.
Oh, yeah.
Or virtually free.
Just do your own.
Do my own Savage Sword of Conan.
Or something basic. Basically do your own Conan character. But make it basically Conan.
Doom Barbarian.
There you go. That's all you got to have.
I'm going to, I'll steal that character like you stole the, what's his name, off of Randy.
Oh, there you go. Just got to make a parody, dude. That's what I can do. Hey, what are you talking about? You're stealing my whole identity, Jeff. What are you doing?
Yeah. That's true. You're in this comic, so
oh,
you have no say.
Oh, man. Hopefully I'm back. Yeah. I mean, a comic, man. Come on. Fair trade, right?
It's true. Pete says all new. Are you going to be doing something for it, Pete?
Oh, yeah. Better be. Tight.
Conan versus a shark or something? Or?
Conan versus Aquaman.
Conan fights the dolphin woman.
With the power of the sea.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Conan travels to Atlantis. Yeah. Gets like some Atlantean like trident.
Booty.
Yeah. Yeah, and booty.
And booty. It's Conan, dude. It's gotta happen.
Pete says, nope, I wish. Well, I mean, I do, but it's, I don't know. Who can do a comic anymore for anybody? I just don't get how it even works, man. I mean, unless you're working for, like, real money. I mean, I don't even see how anybody is working for, like, these indie comic prices, you know? Even though I've kind of heard some of these ones that people throw out, like these writers who go around and try to hire people for Kickstarter. And, like, some of those seem, like, decent, you know? Not that I'd want to do anybody else's stuff, but you know what I mean?
Dude.
Like, I was, like, listening to this one show. I don't even remember, but it's kind of, like, on that Comic Madness Network thing, you know? So it was one of those guys. And, like, one of those dudes was saying he was, like, paying $150 a page. I was like, well, that's not that bad, man. That's, like, probably what you're going to get if you're working for Marvel and stuff. But, man, I might be wrong. I wonder what they pay nowadays.
Dude, send in a portfolio.
No.
Go in demanding. You just go in demanding. No portfolio at all. Just right. Show up. Start demanding. Where do I sit?
That's right.
This is where I'm working.
I'd love to do, like, you know, since they have, like, all these fucking million alternative covers and shit. That would be fun.
You want to do a
cover? No, but like, you know, like the Fire and Ice. Like, I keep talking about that.
Oh, Fire and Ice, yeah.
That'd be neat, but you know.
Hell yeah.
Or Conan would be fun. But you know.
Yeah, do a Fire and Ice one, dude. Definitely for.
But honestly, I'd love to have my own book out. More so than have a Savage or a Conan cover on one that's really never gonna, you know. I mean, what's it gonna do? You know, all these new books and stuff. Nobody even pays attention to anything new. Maybe I'm being a downer.
That's it, dog. I'm deleting. I'm deleting the Indiegogo right now.
So, no, I mean.
Oh, too late.
We got our own books going.
I'm just kidding. It was a joke.
So Pete says, writer-artist John Acuda, Frank Kara, Patch Zitcher, Howard Chaykin, who I know that one, Raphael Kayana, Carrie Nord, which is, that would be cool, because Carrie Nord did that one run on Conan, I don't know, when they kind of brought it back at Dark Horse, I think, and his stuff was fucking badass. Rebecca Poblada or whatever. Dan Panzano. I know him, but I don't know his work that much. Richard Pace. I know him. Gerardo Zaffarino and more. This is the greatest comic news in a long time, says Drawn Sword Comics.
That's right.
Yeah, it's cool.
Breaking right here. You remember that, guys. Just kidding. But yeah, no.
Well, I mean, Conan is in the public domain, though. I mean, I wonder if that means you could actually write new Conan stories like they do with, like, Sherlock Holmes and shit. Or would, like, Marvel somehow fucking, like, come after you or something?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't know.
I don't know. That's a good question.
Who's coming after you, Disney?
No, I'm sure Disney. Well,
that's
a good question because they had him in the Marvel comic universe there for a second, like with the Avengers and shit. Like in modern, you know, like modern, mm-hmm. like a few years ago or something. I remember seeing those on the stands. So, did they got a hold of Conan there? I don't know. But I mean, you know, you can also go, if you go on Amazon, there's like a ton of, you know, just in the public domain, like
republications of like the original stories. So Freno looks cool, says Bronsword. I say we need some Peter Palmiotti on that motherfucker.
I do too, man.
What are you working on, Pete? Like, what do you got your hooks in? We saw you in some, like...
Yeah, Smokes the Fox or something.
Smokes the Fox.
You inked something in there, we noticed.
Yeah, man. Yeah. I saw you there.
Weed Smoking Fox or something. It's also it also had some work by, like, what was it? The background artist for Cerebus or something?
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Gerhard.
That was
what it was named.
Yeah.
That is pretty neat. Gerhard?
Gerhard.
I don't know if he's
Gerhard
even.
Gerhard.
I'm Gerhard. Sure. Is it like that? I don't know. I always said Gerhard, but maybe it was like Gerhard or something.
I'm going to try to warn you there. That's all. Well, Gerard, of course you say it wrong. Of course.
Probably.
I'm just kidding.
But, you know, it's almost like, you know, like when I say Cerebus, do you ever notice how Josh says Cerebrus or something like that?
What? Is that how it is? I thought it was Cerebus.
Well, I've always thought it was Cerebus, but he thinks it's something different. So I'm not sure, you know.
That's it. Fighting. They would.
The liberal version of Cerebus.
How dare he tell people in California say it.
So Peter Palmiotti says designated 5-issue series. I can't read that word.
He's on designated 5-issue series. Did a pinup for Smokes. That's right, because Peter gets around.
Is designated that one we had on the show or whatever?
Yeah, it is. It was global. No, not Global Freakers. What was it? I can't think of it. He did a. He does a. The guy does a radio show for comics.
Yeah, that's him, ain't it?
Yeah,
we had him on there. Yeah.
What is it called? Pete, give it up.
Is it? It's designated though, wasn't it?
That's the name of the comic. Yeah.
Oh, what's the name of the guy?
What's the name of his radio show? Or not.
The guy's name was Casey Kasem.
Casey Kasem. That's right. Oh, Casey Kasem. We're coming back with the top 10 of golden oldies.
That's right. Oh, my God.
This one came out in 1957. It's called I Humped Your Mom in the Back of a Cadillac.
There you go.
That's it. Now you know.
So has there been any new shitty AI versions of any songs that you've come across?
Yeah,
shit. Remember last week you were complaining about that. Did it just like going like crazy now all of a sudden?
Yeah, it was one guy does. I mean, I like them and I shouldn't like them. That's the problem.
Yeah.
Yep, says issue 1 is out, working on issue 2. It came from the radio, Mark Torres. Thank you.
Mark Torres, yeah.
That's it. He's the writer. It's the one where they got everybody but the artist. I remember this book.
Yeah.
I remember this book. Yeah. Oh, boy. Well, he's working on book 2. Did y'all have art already for book 2? Who's drawing this one? You, Pete?
Yeah.
You drawing this one, man? Come on.
Hey, may as well, dude. Jump on in.
Want to let him in?
No, I said no. I said I would jump on in into the drawing.
Ah, okay. Yes, definitely. You should be drawing it, right? He's not drawing it?
I mean, he can't come in if he wants. But...
No, you can't now. No, you just got stiff-armed. That's what that was. No. She might be on my channel, but I'm still taking orders, Pete. Still taking orders.
Yeah, right.
No, don't worry. They didn't even see that intro that I worked all fucking week on.
Oh, man, I know. It was so, like...
Horrible.
Incomprehensible.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. Oh, thank you so much. That's a compliment, right? Oh,
I'm
man.
Sorry.
My God. That was a compliment, though, right?
It was kind of funny. I like the end part where you showed me drawing for a second. That was pretty good.
Yeah, that was good. That's the best part, right? That part you stole out of my video. Yeah, I like that. That was good.
I don't know.
On that.
I don't know that, like, I feel like we probably have like 30 people ready to watch the show. And then it, like, they got to go through 5 minutes of you rapping. They just all leave.
Hey, hey.
Yeah, they're like, this can't be right.
Yes, it's right. That's right. That's it, man. 5 minutes. They got to go through 20 minutes of me rapping. You're damn right they do. I've got a career, man. I watched 5 Mile recently, dude. I think I am the next Eminem.
5 Mile. Oh, is that movie that he was in?
I think so. I'm stretching, man. I don't really know. I think that's it.
Yeah.
I watched Hell High like 15 times, bro, and I think I can be in Wu-Tang now.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
I did like that Eminem movie, even though I thought I was going to hate it. I didn't think that was too bad.
Sorry, it was based on me.
I still haven't seen the Indiana Jones movie, though. I want to go see that.
Oh, the new Indiana Jones movie?
Yeah.
Yeah. So I told you I got a clip of it, dude.
If you watch one movie this summer about a geriatric 80-year-old action hero, make sure it's Indiana Jones and the Curse of the Broken Hip.
No time for sweeping, Dr. Jones.
There you go. That's all you need. That's all you need to know, man. You don't need to go see that movie. Sold.
Is that sold? Is Pete sleeping in the chair? It's Pete with hair.
Yeah, it's Pete. He's wearing a wig. He did that shot for me. Him and his Filipino neighbor. That's who pops out from behind him. Ta-dow! It's okay. Dude, two people left after that. I'm sorry. We shouldn't do that.
Damn. See? Don't rag on Indy.
Don't rag on Indiana Jones, apparently. Damn. Well, come on, man. Indiana Jones. I
just want to see it, though.
I know. I mean,
I know it's probably going to be bad, but I suffered through the last one, and I can't imagine it's worse than that one, but maybe.
You know, he should be handing this over to Short Round, and he's not going to be.
Yeah. You said that last week, and I think that would be awesome.
I already made it better.
I don't know why they didn't think of that, really.
Because they ain't real fans, that's why.
Yeah.
Motherfuckers, I would have handed that shit right over to Short Round. And at the end, I would have just crescendoed it down with, he'd have looked back and said, Swick Shoes. And it's like, oh my God, he said something Goonies. It would have been perfect, dude. Yeah.
Oh. I didn't even get that Goonies reference there.
Damn, you've got the show's over.
Pete says don't make fun of Short Round.
I love Short Round, dude.
Yeah.
Short Round's the best character in the whole damn thing.
The best character in the whole damn thing was like the Frog Brothers. He was there with the
No time for loving, Dr. Jones. It's a Frog Brothers. Well, we just went straight into what the fuck is that? Not Sorry. Friday Night.
Lost Boys.
Lost Boys. Lost all my like, oh, shit, man. It's the Lost Boys. That's it. They redid that to doo-doo.
Yeah, I never did see it, but
thank God.
Yeah,
miss out on nothing, dude. They staked that movie in the heart.
Yeah.
So it'll never come back from the dead.
I feel like that movie was probably just luck that it was any good in the first place. You know what I mean?
Right time. It was just 80s. All those 80s movies, you could have something like that go on, and it was just like an 80s movie could just like leave reality so fast.
I know.
It didn't even matter. It's like, oh, this would never happen, and it was okay. Nowadays, yeah. When it happens, I don't know. It's just like, oh no, that would never happen, man. Oh, I can't believe this.
It's like the CG. It's like too real now.
It is.
Tell it was fake back then. I don't know.
I needed that apparently. All this alien technology, man.
Yeah.
You've been hearing. I haven't been watching any of that stuff though. But apparently, the government's letting out about aliens or some bullshit.
Oh, I've heard that, but is it true or is it just a bunch of comics together saying it? Because that's where I've heard it.
It's a bunch of smoke up your ass from the government.
They're saying that they actually found alien technology or something?
Yeah, or something. I don't know what they're talking about. I haven't been paying that much attention to this alien technology stuff. I've been to other places with the news.
Right.
Did you see and then one last thing about the news. Did you see you know, Mitch McConnell is? Did you see him all fucking like stroke? He like struck out or something.
No.
In front of the fucking in front of the microphone. Yeah, he got all, he like paused there for a second.
Mm.
He locked up like Australia on a COVID fucking scare. So
you know. He had a stroke.
I don't know, man. They came out later and acted like he didn't. But that motherfucker was like talking, well, you know, and then just like stopped mid sentence and just stood there. It's like, man, this is the problem when you can't have these 80 something year old fucking 90 something year old motherfuckers. It's like, what are you still doing there? Yo, Crypt Keeper, time to go.
It is weird. You know, like I remember when like Reagan was president and everybody talked about how old he was. Now he's like younger than anybody up there.
Yeah.
You know? Yeah. What the fuck?
But yeah. That's all the politics we need to talk about. Doma politics.
Let's just go politics all night.
Okay, all night. Here we go. Where's your stance with
this is a political show. Let's get Josh in there.
Let me get my puppet out, because that's what I do. I do political puppets.
Well, you do? It. You got like a side channel with political puppets?
Yeah, I do. I'm trying to start one with Doug to Naples, but he won't do that with me. He's not keen. But I've been working on it, dude. I've been working on it.
Yeah, I don't know. That is weird. Is he still doing the political stuff on any of his channels then?
I think he's got like something. He's got one like, what is it, Doug in Exile or something? It's like political puppets.
And he does puppets?
Yeah, that's what I do. But I'm gonna do puppets.
I see. I didn't realize there was something on the screen. Yeah. Cool.
I'll do the weather. It's fucking hot here in Texas.
Yeah.
You know.
I don't know. I guess the politics shit just forever will not quit. Because, like, I was going to say, is the fervor high enough right now to, like, I'll do that? But I imagine, yeah, if you probably did that, you'd probably find some fucking audience, you know.
Political puppets. I don't know. I'm just kidding, though.
No.
No, I'm not. I got one. It's called Political Puppets, guys. Go check it out. I'm just kidding. I have my political stuff. But, yeah. That's about it, man. I ain't really been doing shit. Been working on this fucking, trying to get this comic out, though. That's for sure. You know, writing as many corny-ass songs as I can. As many shitty-ass rap songs.
Yeah, pretty good. I don't think they're bad. They're funny.
They're supposed to be funny. Hopefully, they're not. No one's taking them too serious. You know, I'm trying to destroy Randy's character as much as possible before he gets that book out.
Poor guy. Which I saw he posted something on Instagram, him coloring or something. So maybe it's getting close.
It sounds like maybe it looks like it's getting close.
That'd be cool.
So,
wonder how many backers he had on that.
How you got me? I can always go.
I wonder if the backers are ragging on him.
Nah. You better not be. Come on. Let's see here.
Well, you'd think there'd be some, but I don't know.
Maybe he's sweet talking.
Yeah, he could be. Give him the old song and dance.
Oh, yeah, dude. What else are you going to do?
Yeah. Nah, I don't know.
What else are you going to do, dude, at that point in time? I guess it's not the best thing to be saying, but, you know. We got an Indiegogo. Yeah, let's look here. He's got 58 backers.
Oh, 58. Okay.
That's what he's got now. It ended with 39, but he's got 58 now.
Oh, cool.
Well, it's set in demand, but it's closed now. It's closed. Yeah.
So what are you going Indiegogo? Are you going to do a fund my comic
I kind of Indiegogo was what I've been working on. Yeah. We'll see what happens with the old FOMO comic. But definitely the old Indiegogo is where I'm at. So that's definitely what my plans are.
Yeah.
You know, I'll back out tomorrow, people. I'll back out tomorrow.
No. Get you delivering this comic.
It's all right. So let's see here. So that's the plan, though. And I've been working on it for real, though. I mean, there's actually an Indiegogo page that I'm got a book on it, but I just got to add some more stuff. I got to figure out how I want to set up these whatever tears or whatever the hell you want to call it. I'm going to cry the tears from my eyes. Those tears, Jeff.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cry when this
goes. Are you gonna have let's see, I'm gonna take a guess. 7-inch vinyl record soundtrack for the book?
I mean, I have some records, so, but I didn't even think about records. I went off in another direction. just trying to get this book done, and now like every time it's like time to put it out, it's like, oh my god, is it good enough? Is this gonna work? Is this gonna fucking work? Is this gonna work? Oh, is it me tonight?
Is it your? Oh wow, yours is gayer than mine, dude.
And I told you, dude. It's like finishing like a fucking video game level. Right?
His mind's over there playing like Beethoven's Ninth Symphony or
something. Man, it ain't. You didn't like the fucking. That you didn't like that Scottish jig? I thought your last name was Lafferty.
I thought your last name was Lafferty. Irish eyes smiling upon you. Irish eyes. Irish spring is smiling upon me clothes.
Yeah, that is some good stuff, Irish spring.
Irish spring. even though I think it's like Bassett. That's okay.
I've
been working on it, man. It's definitely happening. I mean, working on a page right here, finishing up some stuff, making it happen, people. Throw these last few pages in and kick this thing off, not look back, you know, and just kind of do this thing where it's like I put a collection of my stuff in it, and then I'll build another huge collection of stuff and do this again if it's semi-successful.
Sounds good.
Semi-successful. That's all it's got to be.
Yeah. I think that'd be great.
Make a little money.
Yeah. That's the key, too. I mean, like, you know, it's like doing it, and then, I mean, that's where I messed up. Like, I did it, and then I delivered. You got to do it, and you got to deliver. You know, we both did that in the last one. But then we, like, mess up when we don't do the next one and keep it going, you know.
Oh, yeah.
So...
hopefully this works. So, yeah. I'm going to go for it, though. And then what I'm going to do is once I kick it off, I'm going to like move my URL to the campaign. You know what I'm saying? So I can actually just give that easy URL, that www.gibran.wtf.
Mm.
You know? And it's, you know, because right now it takes you to my music if you use it, but I'm going to move it over to the campaign, and then I'll have an easy URL to push.
Yeah.
You know,
I think that's a good idea.
And I have all sorts of like little nifty, you know, little cool stuff I showed before, like stickers and stuff. So I have little things to throw in or little upgrades or however. I don't know how to do all that. I got to figure that out.
Yeah.
But it's slowly happening.
Oh, you know what? I was thinking like, cards is what I was actually thinking, which I guess now that I think about it isn't like some, you know, light it on fire idea. But I thought that might be kind of fun. Like a little card set of like the characters and stuff.
Oh yeah. Oh, little cards. Yeah, it looks like cards are like pretty hot for people right now.
Yeah.
You know, but something else. Because I go look at other people's campaigns, obviously, you know, and kind of see what they're doing and what looks like it's gonna work for them or what did work. One thing I noticed with Indiegogo, when you type in comic book, and like, hold on, let me share my screen. Let's do this real quick. Let's do this on screen here.
Let's present. Present, that's great.
Oh, Josh is here.
Yeah.
Yo, Josh.
Yo. Show this. Don't show these tips. Whatever, man, with those tips. Get it out of here. All right, so share.
Chip's going to share a screen, Josh.
Sooner or later, dude. Sooner or later. Don't you look at my screen, Jeff. Look away.
Well, I should go to the actual stream.
What's going on here? I don't want to see. Be careful.
Be careful.
All right, here we go. Indiegogo. Go River, whatever. Doesn't matter. Just go to Indiegogo. But if I go to Indiegogo and I go over to Second Chance, whoa, what is this here? Indiegogo Second Chance.
What?
For that Kill Reaver. This wasn't what I was looking for, but I stumbled right across it.
You kidding me? Randy's running like a second campaign, Second Chance campaign?
He's always got one kind of set up here if you missed it. He's got a new variant cover with Rob Willis. Oh, cool. Okay, but let's go over here. I'm going to go to search here and I'm going to type in comic book. When I type in comic book, something I noticed here at Indiegogo and I thought was kind of strange is one. Come on, do something. Jesus, making me look bad, computer. I'm doing this good enough on my own. Okay, I noticed that the first book they're showing me is funding, right? It says $50, got 20 days left. And then you go to the second book, it says it's funding. It's got 3,200, but it's ended. It's like, why are you showing me books that have ended?
Yeah, yeah.
21 days left, but then, you know, these are okay, but then ended, and it's like, well, what? There's no live stuff that you could be showing right now, ended, I don't know.
Yeah,
ended, 4 days, ended,
totally.
Ended. It's like, wow. It's like, wow, dude, there's you can't be like promoting some of these little guys that.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm looking at this wrong.
No, I kind of remember
Indiegogo.
Yeah, I kind of remember talking to you about that before with Indiegogo, where it's like, and then we were like looking like for certain books, you know, like the Comicsgate guys are always talking about being shadow banned and shit. But like certain books you just can't find in the damn search. And then I don't know, you know, because like remember at some, one point I was kind of like thinking about maybe going back to Kickstarter because I just like, you know, at least they got a search. At least they have like a comics. Do they even have like the comics category in Indiegogo? I'm not even sure they do.
At Indiegogo?
Yeah.
I put in comics. Yeah, it was like it asked me. It like it had that section.
Oh, okay, so it does have it though.
Yeah, it's like I put that in, not here, but I put it in on when I set the campaign up. So, but yeah, it's like I don't know.
But then yeah. You know, like I was gonna say, you know, I mean, the only other thing is, you know,
fund my comic,
but then, you know, it just, I mean, I hate to say it, it scares me just because it's just like there hasn't been that many big campaigns and I don't know. You set a damn campaign up on all the platforms, isn't that like confusing to people? I don't know.
Anvil, Iron Age Magazine, what is this? Video, it's a Dungeons and Dragons. Uh-oh, don't get me rapping about Dungeons and Dragons. Come on!
That's kind of cool.
All right. Yeah, fund my comics here. I don't know. That's doing all right. Houston, Texas, 27. Hundo.
Yeah. Isn't that Iron Age like a thing, though? That like you're talking about in like Comicsgate or something now?
Oh, is it?
I thought so.
I don't pay that much attention. I guess I need to get back in the loop.
Well, I haven't been paying much attention either, but
I need to be. I need to study up. I'm going to run a campaign. I got to study up. Flip City's got one going here at Fund My Comic.
How much do they? At Fund My Comic? Really?
Yeah, it's right here. It looks like it has no end date, continuous campaign for book what? Volume 18.
See, that's another thing I don't like about Fun My Comic. I don't like that no end date bullshit.
Yeah, you know? Or you can just set up a store and run it forever.
Yeah, I mean, it's almost like if they want to do that, I wish they would just like make it separate, like just, you know, have like a Shopify type thing or something where they could just put up stores, because it's just like, it's not a crowdfunding campaign anymore. Like half the point of a crowdfunding campaign is that, you know, it's limited and you need to go and get it, you know, that's part of what drives them. The thing's just going to sit there forever. Nobody's going to have any motivation to go get it, you know. That's my opinion, but, you know.
That's it, man. That was like, I better remember that shit. That was a fucking pro tip right there, people.
And then, you know, another thing why, like this is one of the big ones why I don't want to go away from Indiegogo, though, with this next one, is because, like, I want to go back in demand. Because I made as much in demand as I made on the campaign, you know.
But yeah.
So it's like, it obviously pays to have that thing in demand, especially if you're working on another one. So, you know.
Yeah.
And Kickstarter don't have that, you know. I don't know.
I get you. Makes sense. I get that, man, but. And so yeah, you're gonna get audience where you drive it, you know. That's the thing. Do you have an audience? You do. Not over here, you don't, but ha. But you got one, you know.
Yeah, but I don't know though. I don't know if that would work or not. I'm not sure I could drive any audience over there. Cause you see other people not being able to. I don't know. You know, it's just risky.
Yeah, the only scare is the new platform. It's not, you know, and nothing against it. It just hasn't, you know, built that big of a name yet.
Yeah.
To where it's not like people have got to put trust into another company. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then how does that work for you? Oh, well, I got your art book from Kickstarter, but, you know, Indiegogo, I just didn't want to go to another place.
Yeah, and I got that message when I went to Indiegogo from Kickstarter, you know, and now I'm going to drag everybody over to fund my comic. I don't know. But I also, like, you know, I also see benefits if somebody can, like, make something happen over there, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be payoffs. I mean, the first guy that goes over there and makes $100,000 is going to be, like, a, you know,
superstar. King of the castle over there, you know? Yeah. It's like, damn, look at that. He can make it work.
But
he's just going for it over there. That's what I just heard. Gonna pull it off. $100,000. I can't get out of his way.
Oh, well, what's her name? So I can make it $1,000,000.
That's it. Seven. Where you at?
Yeah, I need her in there. Pep talking me.
She's going to buy $1,000,000 worth of your books. That's what I heard.
Well, did you guys hear, like, did anybody, no offense, Josh, to bring this up later again, but did you guys hear that interview with, like, Eric July on, I think his name's Well Read or something, on his channel? Did you see that? That was pretty good. It was a pretty good interview, because there was guys kind of ragging on him in the chat and shit, but they weren't reading the chat, and I really liked it, because... You know, he just, he was talking about going out to San Diego, and I guess he got a table there and everything. And so, like, everybody was like, oh, what was it like? You know, what were the pros like and shit like that? And he was totally, you know, like, oh, you know, it was like, everybody was like really encouraging. And you know what I mean? There was just like none of the, like, the drama you hear about, like, all over the internet. And, like, he was talking about, like, talking to certain different people, and they were all, and, but that's how it is. Like, you know, when you go to a con, you know, you don't go to a con and people start ragging on you immediately. Most of the time people are pretty encouraging and
they'll fight you.
Yeah. But I thought it was funny. And then, you know, like, he's now on book two, And on book two, he's up to, I think, 2.7 million now.
Oh.
And it's not even, like, you know, finished out. Like, the campaign's not finished out. So, I mean, I think it was 3.7 on the first one, and now it's 2.7 on the second one. That'll probably hit 3 million. Damn. That is a shit ton of money. I mean, and he's, like, hiring guys now, too. He's, like, hiring different pros to, like, work on these books, like, as writers and stuff, too. And, like, he's, like, really starting, like, a comic book company. I mean, it's, like, it's inspiring, you know?
Hell yeah.
That a guy can, like, fucking pull that off, you know? Because when you think about it, you know, there's always, like, all these levels, you know, like, you know, like, Pete, he's in the chat, you know, he knows what I'm talking about, where it's, like, you know, you get into comics and you stay in your lane, so to speak, you know what I mean, of, like, what you are and what you can do and what you can make, you know, and even at, like, Marvel, they used to set you a page rate, and that was your page rate, no matter who you worked for, you know, unless you went to, like, DC or something, but, like, Marvel had their set page rate, so you didn't negotiate with, each editor, you know, as you came in and stuff.
Yeah.
And so, of course, like, I didn't get, like, Todd McFarlane's page rate or something. I mean, I had, like, mine, which I'm sure was a hell of a lot lower than a lot of people's. And, you know, it's like, but with, like, Eric July, like, that fucking dude, like, everybody's got, like, me, you, Pete, Josh, we all got exactly what that guy's got and what he started with. You know what I mean? We actually got a little bit more because we have, like, the drawing talent because he can't draw. But you know what I mean? It's like a fucking internet connection, a camera. You know what I mean? That's what he fucking did that with. You know, $3.7 million off a fucking YouTube channel. Anybody can set that up. You know? That's awesome.
Yeah.
You know, all you got to do is figure out how to do it, which ain't easy. But, like, he did it. I mean, that is fucking cool. So, I don't know. It kind of pepped me up listening to it. I was like, dang, man. It's like, you know what I mean? Everybody's always like, oh, it's over with, the gatekeepers, blah, blah, blah. No. It's still a Wild West. When somebody can fucking do that, it's like still a Wild West on the internet, you know?
You figure it out.
Yeah, that's like it. I mean, it really is. The equivalent, Jib, of you putting up your Indiegogo and then making $3 million, you know.
Oh my God, I'd have a heart attack. But I would, I mean, not want the responsibility of that.
It's what he did, though. He made a bunch of fucking videos. Like, that's it. I mean, you know, and it's not gonna work for everybody and all that kind of stuff, but it's like, I mean, the, you know, like, you got everything he's got, you know, and, like, me too. And I don't know. It's just cool. Like, what other fucking, like, industry, or what other part of, like, illustration and shit can you say that? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, if I want to work on, like, the cover of, like, you know, I don't know, kids books or something, you know, or, like, whatever, like, I want to be in Spectrum or what, you know, it's like, I got to go ask permission from somebody, you know, and, like, beg to get in there and, like, work and however the hell you do it anymore. But, like, that dude just, like, was like, I'm just going to drive my car right there. You know? And that's what he did, man. And it's like, wow. And that's also, like, what Ethan and, you know, a ton of other people, Jason Brubaker, they all did it. But, like, he's just doing it in a way bigger way.
Yeah, he thought big and just pulling it off, you know. But that's the thing. Okay, here's the thing is, in I want to compare him to somebody that's probably gonna might make some people mad, but
it's like, all right, do it.
Eric July said, "Hey, I'm gonna go for it. I'm gonna take this huge jump, and I'm gonna say I'm bigger than life, and I'm going to throw the dice, and I'm gonna see where it rolls and what happens." And he made it.
Yeah,
that Valerium dude with the comic books with Arrow or whatever. Who's to say he wasn't playing that same game but dropped the ball? You know, I guess because he didn't put, I guess because he was using somebody else's stuff and then in a way ripped him off or whatever, you know. You know what I'm talking about, right? Isn't that his name? What's his name?
Oh, okay.
Valerian. Yeah, Valerian.
The Spence. Yeah, his name. I think his name was Valerian or something. Or Varian.
Varian, maybe.
and like the Spencer's fake deal or whatever the fuck that was.
Yeah.
Where those guys lost all that money on those books.
Yeah, he's just saying he wasn't trying to think big, like, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna get their books, I'm gonna get them in there. I don't know.
Well, that's a possibility if that was like even a real deal. I don't know. Yeah. I still kind of like am skeptical. But you're right. I mean, in some ways, you're right. He's just a guy trying to make it work. And so is Eric July, and so is Pete, and so is me. You know what I mean? It's like we all have these different levels that we're at the moment. But it's like the possibilities. That's what I like. You know what I mean?
For real. That's
the possibility is there.
For real, it's definitely the West, like you said, the Wild West to some extent. It's like it levels the playing field still. There's still like a level playing field out here to some extent. You know, it's not, there's no all this gatekeeping and having to go around a bunch of people and knowing somebody that you can like elbow schmooze to get in. There's a possibility you can.
Right.
You can get out there and do your thing, dance, sing, yell, fucking draw, whatever, and still have a chance.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
You know, at least we're hoping that we do.
So Landon says, what did he do different? Hey, Landon. So he says, so what did he do that we aren't or haven't done yet? I don't know, you know, like, I don't know. Like, he does talk a lot of that, you know, I don't know, what do you call it?
Like, political.
Yeah, hate monger kind of politic kind of shit a little bit, you know, maybe.
Let me get on it here.
Depending on which side you're on, I guess, you know. But he's not, even though he did it that way, and like, say, Ethan maybe does it that way to an extent. I don't know why I said hate monger, but you know what I mean? He stirs up the fans. And not everybody does it that way, though. There's other guys who don't do any of that, and they're making it too, though.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not really sure, like, how Eric July kind of amassed those fans, man, that bought that book.
I know he's got something, I think, to do with Blaze TV.
Well, what's Blaze TV?
It's political, like a news type stuff. It's like where I think Glenn Beck, if you know who Glenn Beck is.
Yeah.
I think he owns Blaze TV.
Is that like a YouTube channel or something?
Well, I think it's like YouTube and I think they got their own .com and all that stuff, you know.
Oh, okay.
They're on the radio. They have talk radio stuff going on. So I think it all kind of stems from talk radio.
Oh, well, that could be. Maybe there's something happening there.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if he got any of those people from that or what. I'm just saying, yeah. I think he has a connection to Blaze TV. You know what I'm saying?
But what's also cool, though, even if say, like, that is, like, the answer with him, though, is, I mean, there's still, like Ethan, he didn't have no connection to, like, that kind of stuff. Like, Richard Meyer didn't have it.
For real.
It's totally still doable. You can get fans on the internet some way.
For real. You gotta, you know. I think you're right about that. I'm not trying to say you're not. I'm just.
Right. But, you know, like, you gotta be right. I mean, maybe that's where that massive number kind of came from or something.
I mean, that's just what I've heard, that he has something to do with Blaze TV. And I'm not saying I don't know anything past that.
Yeah,
I haven't like really looked into it or nothing because I really don't care. He got the number. Who gives a shit how he got it? He hit that number, you know?
Yeah.
Good for him.
So Pete back here says, no Hollywood at the San Diego Comic-Con this year because of the writer strike. Was more about the comics, so I've heard. So was your brother on strike? Is he like on strike with the rest of them?
He said, Pete? The hell with that shit. Fuck it, he said. You know, he said, where the fuck is it? He said, that's what he said right there. Down with AI. That's strike's over, right?
Yeah, but I mean, if he's saying that, he should be on strike because that's what they're striking against, or that's part of what they're striking against.
Down with the AI.
But I mean, he writes for probably some TV and stuff. I mean, don't he? Because like he's got shows or and stuff. Like I saw Frank Miller posting about it. You know, and I know. I don't know.
Frank Miller, with, huh?
Yeah, like he with like Sin City and stuff. He, you know.
So he's still got like a show or something? What's going on with Sin City?
Well, no, but like after Sin City, he did The Spirit. So he's probably in the union too, I would imagine.
Screenwriters Guild.
Right, you know.
SAG. Saggy ass titties. I mean,
Jeff, why would you say that on my show?
Yeah. Well, that's how I like them myself. It could be as simple as that. The political stuff just catches the algorithm, so YouTube recognizes the engagement and pushes it out. Then it gets more engagement, so YouTube pushes it, et cetera, et cetera.
Lies. Pure lies.
Well, I mean,
people landing.
It could be.
Dan Hammer.
But, you know, I also, I don't know. That I mean, that definitely could be with Eric July. Because, like, if you go watch his YouTube channel, it isn't all about art and stuff. It's pretty much about, you know.
Politics.
The liberal SJWs, man. Like, when they're
going wrong.
That's right. Which I love all that stuff. No, I'm kidding. All right,
here we go.
Jimmy's mostly focused on his own books. His writing no for others. Don't know if he's doing only TV movie work right now.
Well, now you know. That was a Jimmy Palmiotti update.
Yeah.
From our man in the field, Peter Palmiotti.
Yep.
That's right, dude. I'm starting my own news channel, dude. Come on.
Your own news? I don't give a shit.
Puppet news, dog. Come on, we're doing it. That's how we're going to make money right here. Bitch.
Puppet news, though?
Yeah, it's got to have puppets, though.
And I would do that with you.
If old Dougie Fresh ever taught me anything, Jeff.
I would have to do it in secret, though, because I wouldn't want anybody to know I was doing it.
I'm not having a secret puppet show with you, Jeff. Don't you ever say anything on camera like that again. Don't you ever. Yes. Oh, my God. Show's over. Show's over, bro.
Yeah. Well, I think, you know, whether politics catches or not, art videos catch, though.
Right.
You know what I mean? Because I've definitely seen a lot of people that do good art videos and, you know, they get attention because of it. So
there you go.
You know, keeping up on your own videos, getting a video out like once a week, couple times a week, that will grow an audience, you know. But you gotta do them well. You gotta be honest with yourself about the quality of your work, I think. That's one thing I see. You get people kind of going like, why not me? Why not me? But then, you know, you really gotta be good enough that, you know, your art catches the eye. And, you know, I guess that's just the truth of it, being an illustrator too, you know.
Write that down.
Right. And, but I mean, you know, if you work hard and you put the time in and you don't give up, you know, in the first like 10 or 100 videos, you know what I mean? And I also think it's like promotion. You know, like people don't, like when I first started on YouTube, I promoted the piss out of my YouTube videos because it made me so mad that nobody would watch them, you know. I was just like, I'm not gonna be some fucking loser with 5 views, you know.
Hey, so
I'd go out and, you know, I'd post them all over anybody's forum I could find, you know.
Yeah.
I know forums are gone now, but
blame me being you.
You don't get fun at views. We probably got 1-5 right now, though.
We got 5. We got 4 right now. So it looks like 4. I love all 4 of them. Come on, Jeff. How dare you? You know. See, after what you said, we need a...
That's Eric July right there.
That's a pro tip, right? That was him flying off with all the money.
That's right.
That's him flying off with all the money. You gotta elbow drop that career, people. Off the top rope. There you go. Get on it. Elbow drop the world.
Only Loki himself could take my hammer, Jib. Should I say, he could try. And he says, okay, for some reason, my brain put hammer in the place of wrench.
Band hammer. That's why. He's a band hammer.
He's the hammer of Thor. That's why I think Frank's not here. I think Frank is in fear. They're like, Landa's going to take out revenge on him for all the shit he put him through.
Shut up, man. I'm going to need a sound effect for when Frank shows up. He goes, that. Woo, 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 woo. Yeah. Woo, totally woo, woo, woo. It's like, damn.
Marshall's back YouTubing, says Peter. He was on Pete Cimetti's recently.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah, is Marshall going to join up with
Alterna?
Alterna, then?
Yeah. All comics gate to the dark side.
Yeah, man. Luke, is Marshall going to join comics gate? Oh, my God.
Marshall, I am your baby daddy.
Yeah. That'd be funny. Yeah, well, I don't know why anybody would really join with Comics Gate at this point, though. I feel like it's kind of over. You know what I mean? It's like, it's cool and all, and if that's what you believe, that's cool. But, like, are you really going to get any fucking push from that? I don't know, man. Yeah.
Just saying, join us.
Landon says, true story, at my day job. Okay, here we go.
Bam, uh-oh.
Never had a wrench before because of this shit.
Take it away. Take this shit away.
I was asked to make an eagle flying in front of an American flag.
Bam.
And the customer wanted him to have red, big eagle balls. Have
real big eagle balls. That's right. Testicles. You know, mountain oysters, I think is what y'all call them, Jeff.
I drew
bog balls on him. As my job required. That's right, Doc. Some old man saggy wrinkle balls on him. Guy kept wanting them bigger. Was it Glenn Danzig?
Is he making funny of the Danzig story?
The balls right there. Those aren't American balls. They need to be bigger. I need bigger balls on him. You know, and he really needs to be weighing him down. He needs to, like, have just total testicular fortitude. You know, America, like what America used to thrive on.
I think I revised it like four times with bigger and bigger balls. Man, I love my day job.
Bigger balls. Right.
Well,
bigger and bigger balls. Jeff had a story like that once with boobies. God bless you, Glenn Danzig. Yeah. God bless you. Bonfire's burning bright.
Well, you got to quit your job, Landon, like Josh did.
I know, man. Just fucking
be a man, dude.
Security to the wind. Just go fucking.
Also, I was wondering, like, I don't know if Josh is still here, but I think Josh should give some tips to Landon on how to sell t-shirts. Because then Josh, like, was good at selling t-shirts at one time or something.
Yeah, I thought t-shirt seller.
Like, how the hell do you sell t-shirts?
Yeah, what's the secret there, Josh?
Yeah,
Landon, inquiring minds, Landon would like to know.
Landon, who is a t-shirt designer by trade, needs tips.
Yeah. Tips. Just maybe the tip. I need to make that. That seems to be my tip thing. For pro tips, he's just the tip.
No.
Yeah, what?
Don't do that.
Just God. It's happening, Jeff. It's already made. I just didn't load it up tonight. I'm just kidding. Okay, now what's going on here? We're getting some pro tips from Josh on how to make the perfect t-shirt to sell.
I don't know. Is it happening?
I don't know. I can wish it.
I could get in on my fake Josh account and start typing and stuff.
Yeah, well, that's why we need a. Yeah, that was something Frank would do. That's for sure. You're not living up, Landon. You're not living up.
Frank would be having a whole conversation with himself.
With himself, yeah. At this point in time.
So, Captain Goggles, how do you feel about Frank's new comic?
Oh, it's so great. Here, let me spam that in Anna Rob's fucking YouTube or email or whatever.
Oh man.
Instagram into the fucking.
You said YouTube. I thought you were gonna say something else with a U.
There you go. Oh boy. What is that stuff called? OnlyFans.
So anyway, oh man, that sounds like a good channel. I'd probably tune in.
Whoa, shut the fuck up. Oh my god, show's over, bro. Here we go. Funny, Jimmy was hanging out with Danzy. Jimmy knows everyone, though. Pinky's out on that, bro. Pinky's out, you son of a bitch.
Yep. The guy finally liked it. He was like, it's perfect. I love it. When the balls were ginormous.
The balls were ginormous. Dude, he wanted them flapping in the wind, dude.
What was he having made? Like an actual t-shirt, or was it like it's like a big like flag to hang in the back of his truck window or something?
Yeah, there you go. No, like one of those big ginormous flags. I know you've seen them. But the guy will have the truck and it has a flag that's like big enough to be at like a dealership.
Yeah.
Flying behind this way, like taking up the whole intersection. It's like beating the car next to it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, you know, I love that. That's what I got on my. We don't have that, Jeff.
No. I don't have that on my Hyundai.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Well, I fought in the war, Jeff.
Yeah.
And by fought in the war, I mean I play Call of Duty. Yeah, so. Sorry. That was a bad joke. Yeah, it's funny. Here we go. It was a t-shirt design, Jeff. It was a t-shirt design for that t-shirt company that he works for.
And, yeah.
It was all about America, you know. Better love that thing, Lynn. That was the most patriotic thing I've heard all fucking day.
How did you draw balls?
Jeff read the description.
Yeah. Huh? How did you draw balls on the eagle? There's no balls. So the SC comic, is it on there? Did you load it up or what?
It was a t-shirt design. No, it's not his. It's he did it for that company.
Oh, I get it.
He did that for the company. There's Landon's actual t-shirt shot. Go check it out, man. He needs people buying these shirts.
Yep. $21. Mm-hmm. Except for this one, $21.95.
Show him, man. Show him. We're going to see him.
All right.
I won't give you permission. You do not. No. Down.
Present. Link
dropped above. Self promo. It's fine, dude. Free shipping.
Screen.
That's right. I'll
Landon
all
Huber.
This one time. Landon Huber.
Did it come up? You guys see it?
I see it.
Got all these cool, which I do really like a lot of these. These are pretty neat. Especially the yellow ones on the black. They sure do look good.
Mm-hmm. Like
this one of this.
The pumpkin head.
Yeah. That one's cool too. I like that one. I was looking at this Halloween one or whatever. Who's this chick here?
Right. Don't you worry about who that is. You look away. I don't know. Who's the chick? Who's the chicky chick?
Is this like a different chick? How come he's got all these girls holding these up here?
Oh, yeah. It's like Photoshopped, man. Come on.
Landon doesn't just have a bunch of models hanging around his house.
Well, I'm sure he does.
This is cool. I haven't seen this one. Cave Monster. The Cave Monster.
That's right.
Art print for $21.
There you go.
Is this like the size thing? Let me check this out. Oh, you can get whatever size you want. 11 by 14 is $23. 16 by 20 is $26. $28 for an 18 by 24.
That's right, people. TV. Yeah.
Looks pretty cool. I don't know why my computer's going so slow though.
Yeah. I'm telling you, you need to like draw another offshoot, like your another version of Big Balls Bald Eagle.
Yeah.
It needs to be on this, man. You know, but yours should be holding an AR-15.
To make it yeah.
more patriotic.
That's right.
Okay.
Just step it up a little bit.
All right.
I want to see like the Landon versus Frank t-shirt with like Landon on one side, Frank on the other.
There you go. Landon versus Frank.
Yeah, man.
Two enter, one leave. You know what I'm saying?
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
I'll see the Banhammer t-shirt. All right, that's it. Enough of this. Thank you, really.
All right. Let's go through some of this here. Says
the girls are for showing the print sizes. Oh, okay.
Now you know. Thanks, Pete. Been working hard. I don't talk about that. Don't be in bed talking about that. Great looking shirts there, Landon. And now you know. Somebody go buy a shirt.
Yeah, go for it.
So I can demand 10%.
No more Halloween stuff then, Jib. From now on, it's giant eagle balls all the way.
Hell yeah, man.
Key to success.
Eagle balls. Down the of Congress Hall. Sing a song. About eagle balls. It'd be the most patriotic song ever.
Well, did the Halloween thing work during Halloween then? Or was it just out of curiosity?
No more Halloween stuff. That's right. How dare he? You know, some people have Halloween every year. That's how Spencer's and Hot Topics stay open.
Yeah.
Some people don't realize that Halloween is once a year.
Yeah. So
get those kids in there and you're like, yay. You know, those kids that have like Edward Scissorhands and The Nightmare Before Christmas on loop.
Yeah. Got the King Cobra.
Yeah, copy King Cobra. Oh, man. Haven't checked in Hotel King Cobra in a while.
Yeah, I went over the other night and I was like listening to like the latest. There's a lot of
alcoholism and stuff.
Oh, yes. You know, I go there to watch a man deteriorate.
Yeah, well, I was watching, like, you know, the guy who makes videos about him, not his videos.
Oh, yeah. The mini bites or whatever they're called. Cobra yeah. bites.
Yeah, I think it is, like, bite-size cobra
yeah.
vids or something like that.
Bite-size cobra vids, I think that's it.
But he, like, I was the one I was watching, he, like, he can you believe, like, how old do you think that guy is?
I think the thing is he's way younger than he looks. He's like drinking himself to fucking old age.
Yeah.
I think he's really like in his early 30s?
He's 31.
Yeah.
He's 31 years old, Are you kidding me, man? Yeah, because his birthday just happened. And so basically on his birthday, like this is one of the things that happened in this video. So on his birthday, he basically sits there and streams for like 5 hours. And right. It's like parents are going to come and take him out for his birthday and just gets completely shit-faced. And then they call him up, you know, like 5 minutes before they're going to leave, wanting to know if he's ready. And he's like slurring. He's like, I'm almost, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so they're like, you're completely like fucking drunk, dude, you know? And so they don't take him anywhere because he's like so shit-faced, and then he just sits there like
it's all mad at him,
exactly, and like yeah. tells the story, which is like right on camera. He talked to them on camera, you know what happened, and yeah. it's like this whole different version. And yeah, and so then they like came over the next morning and took him out for breakfast or something. But I mean, what a fuck up, man. Like, you can't even stay like sober long enough for your parents to take you to dinner. I don't know.
You know, internet gold.
Internet gold.
Got me beat.
I mean, that's, I guess, like his thing is his stock and trade is just being kind of a screw up, I guess.
Yeah. Well, I do. It's like, what's funny is I watched that other guy. I think I told you that, like, he just downed 40s on the fucking stream.
Oh, that dude. Yeah. That was. It was a whole new level, man.
Yeah, dude, that guy's just like, he's like eating popcorn and down in fucking 40s on the stream. It's like, I find the lowest of lows on the internet, apparently.
I know. But, I don't even see where, like, you find someone. Or the guy who paints himself black.
Oh, yeah, dude.
That one was crazy.
What was his name? Nuka something. Was it? Nuka something.
Yeah. Oh, and he basically takes some kind of drugs that make you, for like sun tanning, and he takes so many of them that he's turned himself black.
Yeah, and he swears he's black.
Yeah, and then there's like black people that are like telling the internet to knock off this thing of like people telling him he's not black because he's actually black.
Yeah, he's
but he's white. He's actually white at the beginning. He like somehow got his skin color. It is crazy.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, I mean,
I don't know.
What would I do without the internet nowadays? Like, how do I live without it? It's like, you know, there were some rough times, dude. But it's the internet's eased out for me. You know, rough time. It was like, you know, back in the day, it was harsh, man. There was like stuff like Goatsy you had to navigate through.
Oh, like the road bad sites, yeah.
Yeah, you don't remember Goatsy? That was horrible.
I don't know. I'm sure I've been the ones that are the equivalent of that, but I don't remember.
Then there was the two girl one cup era of the internet.
Yeah,
that's right. You're like, oh my god, yeah, I'm saying it. So this was really bad times, and now it's eased up.
I'm just kidding. Yeah,
just being silly. It says, have we read this yet? We will see this year how things go. I actually had just started the store around 1 week before Halloween last year. Been slowly building the shop since then. Cool. You're hoping for like a huge Halloween hit, or that's the goal, to target market the Halloween.
Yeah.
Halloween.
You gotta do some more videos, Landon. You know? Really well.
Good. No, I say don't do it. Hold on a minute. Time to put out another comic book, Landon. You know, eat up half your life. Make no money. Get divorced. You know, it all sounds awesome.
Yeah. I know. It's kind of funny, but yeah, you're right. It's like there's been several people now who, you know, start a comic and then get divorced. It's like kind of crazy. You're taking a risk, man.
Yeah. Women just don't want to see it so demasculating, throwing a comic.
Yeah.
And that woman getting turned on by that. That's how it is.
I've been recording stuff, just the editing takes time. Yep.
Oh,
this is a bitch.
Yep. Editing. How dare y'all? How dare you edit anything? Just throw it up there. So this year, I'm choosing to focus more on the store. That even rhymes, dude.
I'm heading out. You guys can go another few hours.
Oh, man.
We're just going to start talking to you.
So you stick, I don't know. We got to talk to you about some stuff, dude. There's questions I have.
We got some important stuff we need to like have a discussion about.
About your brother.
No, this is pertains to Pete.
Oh, is Aquaman related?
Yeah. Aqualad.
Aqualad, yes. the truth again.
That's right.
The true hero in that story, Aqualad.
Aquaman and Blue Beetle love each other.
And Blue Beetle teamed up with Devil Dinosaur, and Aquaman teamed up with.
Oh, things got real.
Martian Manhunter, who would win? You need your professional opinion on that.
Anyway,
come on, hold on. We're gonna wait on that. Just sit here in dead silence until you type out a fucking answer, dude. Right. Once you stare at the fucking chat intensely, like, let me know too. With the strain, I want your fucking nose to bleed. Oh man, horrible.
Yeah.
So,
Dang it, I broke the tip off a pencil after all. Uh-oh,
you know what that means. Comic's over. Shut it down, Jeff. Yeah. Shut it down. So,
it's funny. I've noticed that these ones I bought here, like I bought a whole bunch of boxes of them, and they seem to get softer towards the end for some reason. They're, like, pretty hard for about three quarters of the way, but then when I get down to the bottom, they seem to be a little bit softer.
That's right. It's that, it's that fucking man grip you're putting on that fucking pencil.
Well, it could be.
Just kidding, man.
Gas grip.
Right.
Hold your pencil as tight as possible.
I do. I do, man. I try to. That's how I get them rigid lines. Dig them in. Like I'm tattooing still.
Oh, jeez. Is that what you got to do when you're, like, tattooing? Like, just really jab it in there?
You got to hold that machine fucking, though, like death grip.
Oh, yeah, because it's vibrating. Vibrating.
Yeah. You're trying to like keep it steady. Jeez. You know, you're trying to run it across that line. You stretch him with that other hand, you, like stretch that skin with the other hand and like hold it firm. Like I lean on you and stretch that skin and then take that fucking my drawing hand.
It's weird.
And when the needle stops, you know, you're in. No, I'm just kidding. That's horrible.
I don't think that's another thing I would like about tattooing is I don't think I'd like to have to touch people all day.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
You don't know these people, man. You don't know these people.
What's like the weirdest body part you've ever tattooed? Let's hear it.
I don't know, like right next to like vaginas.
Oh man. That's what I wanted to hear.
That's that what you wanted to hear?
That's what I wanted.
I didn't like, you know.
Well, what did you tattoo on
No peckers like or anything. Like weird. Like I don't know. People get weird stuff. Like girls will get like a man's name anywhere. Dude, it's like, oh, like, why did you put my boyfriend's name? It's like, well, bitch, you cheated. The only reason he's marking territory is because one of y'all either you cheated or he cheated. One of y'all, somebody cheated in this situation. Guaranteed. You getting a name? Somebody cheated.
Would that stop you from cheating with a girl if she had the name of a different guy down there? I'd probably still go for it.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I don't think most people can. Well, you know, it's like usually you put the name. Here's the thing is usually you put the name on the girl, right? And then you're like, well, see you in 2 weeks, see you in 3 weeks, 2 or 3 weeks. They're coming in and you're like, can you cover this? And like, yeah, I'll put a rose over it. Bam, double trouble. I'm gonna pay you double. I'm gonna pay you double. When it's time to cover it.
That's funny.
I'd say that shit all the time. I'd laugh. I'd laugh when they come in, dude.
God.
Be great. Like, oh, what are you doing here? What are you doing here? Can you get that name covered up, huh?
Yeah.
Told you. Fucking told you right in front of your man, too. Didn't care. Like, you ain't going to want this in like 2-3 weeks. What happens when y'all break up? Man, we ain't breaking up. Yeah, mm-hmm. You're getting this man's name by your vagina. Like it's an expiration date. Get the fuck out of here. So, yeah. There you go.
That is weird, though.
I tattooed. These girls came in and got Jesus fish tattooed by their vaginas.
Wow.
Like, that is like wrong in so many like levels.
Sin right there.
Like it's like one, yeah. Really? A little Jesus symbol? But well, like you know. And then second of all, you tattooing a little fish down there. Yeah. Makes total sense.
I think it would like take me out of the moment a little bit. Like I'm down there doing my thing and then all of a sudden like I'm my left brain kicks in or something, you know.
Yeah, you know. And then you got those girls that are just completely tatted up and they do all sorts of weird shit down there.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh man, what are you making me try? What are you trying to make me do?
It's weird. Yeah, chicks are weird. Chicks are like, they always act like we're so weird. They're so much weirder.
Hell yeah. For sure, man.
Yeah.
But yeah, they always want girls are like weird about shit too. It's like they want the same like tattoo as other girls. It's like they all like, oh man, I got this flower blowing in the fucking wind, turning into birds. And it's like I found it on Twitter and every other bitch has this fucking thing tattooed on them and I want it to.
Oh jeez!
Oh my God! Are you fucking kidding me? That's how it is. Or that's how it used to be. I mean, I don't know. I got out of tattooing. Tattooing was fucking aggravating for me. I'd come home just so fucking mad. Hated all that shit I was doing.
Yeah, I could. It just, you know, it just, what it sounds like to me is like commissions, except for
it is. Yeah. But it is, dude.
Just like a million stupid ideas. You're trod for me.
And the difference is instead of them sending you some fucking note on the internet to you where you're like, oh my God, what kind of bullshit is this? They're saying it right to your face.
Yeah.
Yeah. So they'll, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, how did you get into the tattooing? Because I kind of remember, I remember you buying some of my stuff.
I was already tattooing. I was already tattooing back then. Yeah,
I thought you were tattooing at that point. So
yeah, I was already tattooing. I got into tattooing, went back to my hometown where I was growing up, and there was a tattoo shop. Some friends of mine were getting tattooed there. I went in there and just showed them some work, and next thing you know, I was apprenticing, you know.
Oh wow, okay.
So that's basically, you know, because it was like, oh, I got to do something. I was kind of coming out of being in like some bands and stuff, and I was kind of like at the time like, oh, I'm getting too old for that. I got to do something else. Well, I got to get into something, you know.
Yeah.
And I was like trying to stay out of plumbing because, you know, I was like, I want to draw or do something else, and
yeah,
there's a way to make money.
Well, plumbing's not so bad. You just don't want to fucking have to draw t-shirts for the rest of your life.
Oh, yeah. Draw t-shirts? Yeah, there you go. But don't. Shit. Plumbing sucks. Drawing t-shirts. So.
Yeah.
It's rough. I don't know. So that's how I got into tattooing, basically.
So, Landon says they have cooties. But that's why you wore those, like, rubber gloves, right?
Yeah. So you got that, you know. You got to fucking take a bunch of bloodborne pathogen classes and stuff to teach you how not to spread cooties.
Oh, really?
Yeah. That's like they care more about that than your fucking art skill.
Oh, wow.
They don't give a shit if you're fucking doodling fucking.
So what? Like stick
figures on people.
There's like a bunch of health stuff that you got to do when you tattoo. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, dude, you got to follow shit. You don't be giving people fucking AIDS or Hep C. You know, it doesn't sound like fun. Hey, come in for a tattoo and then leave with Hep C.
I wonder, like, you know, if you're getting, like, a tattoo, like, you know, remember how Darren was tattooing out of his apartment and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if he was, like, doing, like, all the health stuff or whatever.
I'm sure you can buy it all, man. You know, it's,
oh, can you?
Here's the thing is, most people would be like, oh, you shouldn't tattoo out of the house, and you shouldn't. You shouldn't tattoo out of the house. That's for real. But most tattoo artists are fucking liars when they tell you, oh, I don't tattoo out of the house. It's like, yeah, well, you have at some point, guaranteed, because that's just how it is. That's just,
I'm sure probably everybody kind of starts that way or something.
And it's anything, dude. It's like sometimes you're on the road or something, and someone's like, oh man, you just give me a tattoo, and it's just like, it just happens.
Yeah, you're like in prison.
I mean, prison, you know. You stabbed that bitch. You told her she weren't putting up with that shit. You're going to have a tattoo career. And you stabbed her 17 times in the fucking neck. And now you tattoo it in the fucking pen in between your fucking burpee sessions and doing fucking push-ups. You got to be dope. You know? Nice. You know, try not to get jumped in the yard.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, going down with manslaughter.
Yeah.
Well, you know, gotta have street cred though, dude. They can't, those rap albums aren't gonna fucking drop without street cred.
Yeah.
Just can't be out there getting his chain stolen, you know. This advice, I'm giving out advice here, how to be hard on the streets. There we go.
Yeah.
Gangster till the day I die, Jeff.
Is that right?
We don't just fuck, we multiply. Bam! All right. Oh man.
Yeah.
So, you been playing any tambourine, dog, or
who, me? No.
Yeah. Oh man, I thought you were gonna start playing the tambourine.
Oh.
Picking up the ukulele or something.
Do I need to do that?
That's right, dog. Something, you know.
I don't know why I would need that.
Yeah. I've been trying to learn how to play the ukulele. I've learned a couple of songs on it. Yeah. We got a ukulele for the kids, and you know, it's like, oh, it's a, you know, of course I'm gonna play it.
It's a fucking ukulele. I gotta play it.
Yeah.
So.
Is it hard? Is it like an electric one that you can plug in or something?
Nah,
is there such a thing? Is
an electric I think there are. I think there's such a thing as an electric ukulele, probably. Some idiot's got one out there. But
there's the key. I got this for you, Jevon. Here, like, get this. Mm-hmm. So you make a YouTube channel, and you play the ukulele, and then you do, like, the Star Wars theme, the theme for Battlestar Galactica.
Battlestar Galactica. How does that go? I don't even remember how the theme goes to that shit.
I have no idea. But yeah, there's this one electric guitar dude I saw doing that was big. Oh. And he would do like a real like Metallica version of like, you know, Star Wars or Blade Runner or whatever, you know what I mean? Movie themes, and that got him popular.
Oh, and popular, that's what I need to do. I'm fucking up, Joe.
That's all you got to do, Landon, and then you get fucking sell those t-shirts. Like,
dude, sell those t-shirts, fucking hand over fist, bro. And booyah, next thing you know, got a fucking OnlyFans. You're doing fucking porno. Oh, wait, what? What are we talking about?
What in God's name?
What? It's the after-hours show, Jeff.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Never. Never again.
Well, I was telling you about those those girls that did the porn comic. Remember that before the show started?
Yeah, that was one thing we were talking about. That was the one thing that's what I was like, damn, I can't believe. I'm kind of glad we didn't say that on camera.
Oh, you don't want me to go back into it? Because there was a part.
I don't give a shit, really. I mean.
Well, these two chicks, like, they started talking, which I thought was kind of funny, but they were talking about how, like, if they couldn't make it as artists, you know, drawing, like, their porn comics or whatever.
Right.
They could, like, shoot, like, videos. Like, of course, they kind of tamed them down. They're like, well, I could shoot videos of, like, me putting lotion on my feet.
Putting lotion on your feet. That's right.
Just stuff like that.
Make your daddy proud, girls. Make your daddy proud.
But they were like acting like that was, you know, like, oh, well, I can't do that. But then, like, you know, when I was looking at what they were drawing, it was like that furry porn stuff. I was like, God, isn't this way worse? You know? I think just getting naked wouldn't be as bad as like the stuff you're drawing. You know?
Furry porn, huh?
Yeah.
So that's just like mascot humping.
Pretty much, I guess. Yeah, it was like a, you know, like wolf people, and well, the one chick had a comic, and it was like a dragon, like a full size dragon, and then like a chick that had like dragon wings, and I don't know, she might have been some other animal too, because she had like a tail.
Down. She getting down with the dragon? Is that
she was getting, getting.
Do you get down with the dragon? Get down with the sickness, or no? You get down with the dragon, bro.
There you go.
Now we know. Now we know, and no one tapped a battle. GI motherfucking Joe.
Yeah. I'm sure everybody was like, yeah, what the fuck are they talking about?
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure you were, because, man, I don't know if I had a handle. I'd be like, what the fuck? Can't go into that chat room. I might cause problems.
Well, there was nobody in there. I was, like, kind of looking and seeing if they had, like, fans, and then one had a Patreon, and I went over there and I kind of looked.
Whenever you subscribe to their OnlyFans, how many people were in there?
There's no OnlyFans that I saw. Oh, so
that you saw. I see. Good man. Good man. I like what you said there.
Well, no, they had like a
page. I know, I got you. No, I get you. You gotta do research. You gotta do research, dude. I understand.
Well, I was looking. I mean, I probably would have looked if they were if it was there. But, yeah. The one chick was on camera and drawing.
Uh-huh.
You know. I guess I haven't said who these people are, so they won't really ever know that I'm saying this. But she wasn't much to look at, really. She was kind of a dumpy little fat chick. And robot. Then the other one was like off camera. And, you know, she sounded hotter, but
who knows? Uh-oh.
You know, uh-oh. How that goes.
Yeah, man. Turn out to be a man. There we go.
But the one chick, like, was doing the webcomic, and it was, like I was saying, you know, like a dragon and a whatever.
Yeah, well, that right there rats them out, I'm sure, if he knows who they are, so.
Well, you know, I don't know, though, because it's like, it wasn't even, I mean, like, would anybody in the Arcasters know who this is? I don't know.
Probably not. It doesn't matter if they do.
Anyway.
So we're causing, that's it. We're calling you out, bitches! We're calling you out!
Yeah.
Now, I thought this ain't war.
But I was kind of just watching it because, like, they were talking about making, you know, their Lebanon artists and stuff. So I was kind of like, you know, just curious how they were doing it. And so I was like looking around, you know. And they both had like pages with like all the links. Like Frank has like that link page where you click a link and they kick you like a page with like a ton of links. And so I was like clicking all those. And they had like a lot of, you know, commissions, kind of like, here's my, you know, buy a commission, like a half page is this much, a full page is this much, and here's what kind of stuff.
You said that they had how were their comic books doing?
Well, the one had a comic, and then I couldn't find a comic for the other one. But the one just, I don't know. I mean, she had a Kickstarter, or she actually had three Kickstarters. And her latest one made, it was like pretty low. It was like 4,000 or something. Yeah. You know, it wasn't like ridiculously high or anything. Yeah.
You know, can't hate on that. Can't hate on $4,000.
Mm. No, I mean, it was, you know, you're doing it. I'm not like busting on them.
Yeah. Well, I was, but not anymore. I got to give them some respect all of a sudden.
But the comic was up on like, on all the webcomic sites, but it was like a censored version. And so I read through some of it, you know.
So yeah,
it was okay.
If you want to get down with fucking mascots, you gotta buy that shit. I see that's good marketing though. But I can't hate on that. Can't hate on that. I'm doing this wrong. I'm gonna have to draw that instead of teddy bears fucking in the forest. What?
I think that stuff would get just as boring as anything though, after a while.
You know, after I pay the electricity bill a few times, I'm sure.
I guess that's true.
Oh, that's right, people. I'll just wash that shame off in the shower. Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't. If you're gonna do it, I mean, I probably wouldn't be ashamed of it. You know what I mean?
But I wouldn't either.
It's just like, I don't know. I own up to whatever I do. So
have you seen what I'm doing on the internet yet, Jeff? You mustn't be watching these shows. Yeah. I got no shame. No shame to this game, boy. What are you playing, man? Turn it off. We're gone. How dare you? What page?
This is still page 13.
So. Still page 13. It looks good, man. It's coming along.
Yeah, it'd be nice if I could get it done before like next week. That'd be really cool, but I don't know if it's gonna happen. And I'll probably end up getting done when I get back. So,
gotcha. Just come back, man. You got to come back and attack the page.
That's what I'm planning on doing. Like really push and try to get it all done before, like, you know, like winter. You know, like Christmas time kind of thing. Mm-hmm. That'd be nice.
Yeah. See, I'm scared to say this, but I'm gonna go ahead and say it. Like, it asks, you know, like, when do you think you'll have the book out? I'm hoping, like, you know, October. You know, I'm hoping.
Yeah.
Run the campaign and just put it right out. You know, that's the goal.
Oh yeah.
Because I'm trying to finish these last couple pages real quick, like while I'm finishing up the campaign, and then going for it. You know.
Yeah.
And going for it. So that's my plan. And if I just stick with it, you know. And like, I got a couple more pages that are necessity. And then everything after that is just kind of stuff that I'm like, you know, I want to make the book a little bigger. Because it's like, I look at these books these books that people are charging $20 for. Some of these books have a lot of pages, you know, and I'm getting it. And I'm not hitting that kind of page count, but I'm in the 40s, you know. I think I'm trying to, like, but the minimum I'm trying to hit is 48 is minimum.
Yeah.
You know, and then, but I've got, so far, I think I got a few more extra pages, I'm hoping. And then I, you know, kind of see if I can add a couple more things here and there. And so, you know, that's my goal. And then right now, I've got the price of the book at $13. And then shipping is, I want to say, $3 to $4. In states, and then obviously out of state shipping is out of control,
right? Yeah.
So, and then and that's just for the book.
And, well, I guess 3 to 4 is like media mail, probably, on a book.
Yeah, that's what I'm going for. Yeah. You know, now I have shipped a lot of stuff media mail, and hadn't had any problems recently. Yeah. My wife took something out of a record that we were mailing off. And she mailed it, and they like started giving her a bunch of grief over it. But like, we're opening this, we're taking this in the back, and we're going to open. And it's like, yeah, fucking open it, dude. Could get fucking bent, you know?
Yeah.
Open that motherfucker. I don't give a shit. Make sure you close it back up properly.
Yeah, there you go.
Fucking open it. So.
I don't know. I would just ship most stuff. You know, just first class, because like I got tired of that. But I know like in Boulder they did that shit. But then like when I got up here to Loveland, I never had any problem with any media mail stuff.
We got first class, man, or that priority mail or whatever, like $7, or it was.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I can't remember, but I bet it's there now, because it was around $5 at least for just a comic, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like if I sold a Berserk or not, and then I would just have, you know, two pieces of cardboard tape tight all the way around in a manila envelope. That's how I was shipping.
Mm-hmm.
And it'd be like a bagged and boarded comic, so it'd be plenty safe. But that was like that kind of price would be, and I'm pretty sure they were all about $5 something when they would go like first class.
And that's five something.
Yeah.
Still, you know, they eating profit, man.
Totally.
So, and that's
especially for the first run too, because I remember when I did when I fulfilled the campaign, like the major bulk of them, you know, most of those went media mail. And then it was kind of like when I would sell, like it went in demand, you know what I mean? And when it was just like one, two, whatever, it was just kind of random. Those were like more like the ones I was just like, go ahead and send them, like whatever, not priority, but first class, I guess.
So yeah, I gotta. That's where I'm at right now. It's just putting all that stuff together, trying to figure out like what the tiers are gonna be, and finishing out these last couple of pages. You know, I've kind of got that one page kind of done. I think it's about where I want it. So, kind of got me moving, and now I'm kind of finishing this up.
Yeah.
And then, like I said. I got to do a front, what is it called? like a index or whatever, front page, table of contents, whatever it's called, where the stories are,
title page
or whatever. And I mean, I'm pretty much everything else is just kind of like add what I want to just have some fun with it. And that's it, man. So it's going.
That'd be cool.
So yeah, I don't know. It's getting close, really close. And like I said, I'm going to tag the URL to it. I just got to figure out the last couple of stuff I want to add. I want to add some stuff. And like you said, I got seven, you know, I got actually 10 inches from the last time I did records. And then I do have some, like, you know, I could do some 7 inches. I wanted to.
Yeah.
So I could do some stuff like that in there. But yeah, and the other stuff, it's weird that I have, like, I printed a bunch of fucking skateboards at one point in time.
Oh, wow.
You know, I might add some, I might just add one or two of those to see, but then I have the original paintings too. So
yeah,
I might throw those up, you know, just little things like that. And then I don't know, it's like draw something in the book or I don't know.
Right. Yeah.
You know, I don't know. Maybe something like that, but I don't have like a ton. I keep looking at other people's things they did. You know, like you said, a little card set's pretty cool, but it's something I'd still have to put together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, to put a little card set together for this. So
yeah.
But I noticed it's a big hot thing lately that people are definitely doing card sets.
Well, I was thinking like, you know, if you, that'd be like, you know, you could buy like bigger postcards and just like cut them. You know what I mean? Then that'd be like,
yeah,
postcards. Or I mean, that'd be like a card set. Just put it in a little bag or something. I don't know.
For sure, dude. No, for sure. You know, it's like, do you do the drawing in the book or do you do an actual little commission or something? I don't want to, you know, I really don't. I think I just draw in the book because don't want a commissions list. I don't want people, it's horrible sound. I don't want people in control of what I'm going to be drawing. I definitely, right. That's one thing. And maybe that's a bad thing with me, but I've always just like, after tattooing, man, it's like, I don't want people in control of my drawing.
Yeah, but, I really hate like drawing for people anymore, but. You know, I definitely did plenty of it for sure.
Oops.
I don't know. Like, I think if I run another one, and I think I did that with the Berserker Knot. Did I do a commission list? I might have, though.
I don't know. You know, you sold art. I know that. I don't know if you did a commission, but I thought you did at the end. I thought you did some commissions or.
I definitely.
Berserker Knot style.
Right. Because I remember, yeah, like, I remember doing this one, like, Transformers, which I, like, the Transformers always hate drawing the Transformers, you know? And then, of course, it was, like, a Transformers. I remember doing that for somebody, so that probably was in the campaign, you know? Because it's, like, I can't imagine, like, I sold that commission separate, because I did it in, like, the Berserker Knot style, you know? So... But I don't know. Like, if I do it again, it's like I'm definitely going to try to, you know, maybe sketches in the books. But, oh, man, I just want to stay away from commissions and stuff, you know.
Oh, yeah, I feel you, dude. Like, those are so controlling of my time.
Yeah, I guess everybody does them, though. You know, it's funny, like, Pete was talking about Kerry Nord because I follow him on Instagram. I'm always seeing him post commissions.
Uh-huh.
You know, the guy's still cranking out commissions for people. And also, like... I see, like, Adam Hughes, or not Adam Hughes, but Art Adams. It's, like, another one of the artists I really like from back in the day. He's, like, an old man. He's still doing commissions.
Yeah, until the end, man.
Yeah. Always happen to draw a fucking Hellboy from somebody, you know.
Like, right. Yeah. He sets up, you know, it could be fun, you know, I guess.
Yeah, but, if you're into it, I guess.
So...
Some of your songs are very melodic, Jib. Those ones are some of my favorites. Drunken in Love, Love You Pumpkin, some faves. Yeah. You guys should like collab, dude.
Yeah, oh, man. Yeah.
Do a ukulele.
Ukulele collab. There you go. Bust up the ukulele, man. Don't make me. It ain't tuned. I'd have to tune it for 20 minutes.
Yeah.
But yeah, you know, I don't know. But the thing is, once you learn guitar, you can just kind of like, okay, if I know these notes, I can play these songs. And then it's kind of like, I'll learn these notes on the ukulele. Now I can play those songs.
Yeah.
Kind of how I look at all that stuff.
Well, that makes sense.
And I just move it all over.
Yeah.
So once you know how to do that, you can cheat. You can cheat.
The one thing I want to do, like when I run my campaign, though, is I want to have some kind of animated thing for the campaign, man. I've been trying to think of like a real simple kind of like, you know, like just some gun shooting or something and like pan up on a picture kind of thing or something. But I do want to do something for it, you know.
Hell yeah. Oh, show, man. Oh, what is that freaking, let's see here. I wanted to mention this, but
I'll have to grab some music off of you too.
Oh yeah.
If you don't mind.
No, dude, for real. What was this? Skunk Artworks is a guy I follow on, I think you follow him too on Instagram.
Yeah.
He's got like he's got an Indiegogo that he's working with some people. And I'm gonna show it off like a little thing off here real quick. And then
totally.
Yeah, because he keeps posting that thing.
Yeah, you know, and I want to show it. So it's right here. It's called Kill Them Dead. There's like a picture, a painting for it because it's a fully painted comic book. Looks awesome. Wow. I love it. So check that out right there. It's got like the production mock-up stuff here, but he's doing this thing where it's like, I think it's like a rock opera. He's working with some other people. It says right here, like Blacklight comic book rock opera. So Kill 'Em Dead is an action horror comic book and power metal rock album featuring 80 plus pages of Blacklight retro active art and two vinyl albums with over 80 minutes of music. So they're going for it. So yeah.
That's pretty neat.
Pretty dope. And then it's got a little thing here we'll watch. Well,
so is it active yet or not?
No, it's got a mailing list.
That's cool. Is it playing? I don't hear nothing.
You don't hear it?
Did you share it?
Is it not? You can't hear that?
No, I'm not hearing nothing.
Oh my God. Effing kidding me right now, Jeff. Are you effing kidding me? It's it, dude. I'm leaving. I don't know how to hit that fucking button, apparently.
I don't know why they have it on there. It's just dumb.
Let's kill Reba. That's not it either. Oh my goodness, man. Give me a second. Oh, that's mine.
You know what Landon meant by some of your songs are very melodic, yet.
It means they suck. Here we go.
He means that, like, stop with the fucking rap.
Okay, I will. I will. rap's just to make me laugh, man. Okay, just check it out. Here we go. Your speculation, just an educated guess. Can you hear it now?
Yeah. Yep.
The lords of the underworld await. You will clash steel upon bone, blood upon rotten flesh, and fill this void with light. You must answer this call, Husk. You will be the one that will finally kill them dead.
That's awesome.
Coming soon. Now you know, people. Flex on it. Flex with it. There you go.
It's a cool video, for sure.
That's all I have. Let me go back. There's this, too.
I'm liking his art. I wonder if he's Reba. I guess I just figured that he was like doing that with somebody. But you know, maybe he's is that like his actual campaign and stuff?
No, I think he's doing it with somebody.
Yeah. It is Kill Reaver.
Yeah.
Finally, the long awaited Kill Reaver.
Coming out so you can buy it a second time.
Pulling a Peter Palmiotti. Run it four times.
Run it four times. That's how you do it, dog. Learn something. Then well, you got this.
Ethan did that. He did the second chance then too.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
Oh, Mike's got another one up too.
I guess this is, isn't it? July 9th, I guess, last updated. So maybe.
Cool.
Maybe not. There's this going. Or you can't buy them no more, or what? I guess not.
It's already over. Like, Mike runs it for like a week. He's like, that's enough.
Right. He's got the Peter Palmiotti method going, bro.
I know.
Look at that painting, people. Y'all wish.
I know. And then look at, like, this is what gets me, the people who bitch about Mike. Like, look at all those fucking covers. Yeah, like, he's done, like, 15 issues of a fucking magazine, like, himself.
Yeah, himself. Got a couple, like, maybe one of the guys drawing every once in a while with him.
Yeah.
Ended up. But, yeah.
That's a workhorse, man.
You can buy them all right now for $175.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Oh, yeah, dude. Kill it. Probably better off buying them over here and his YouTube thing, though. Just been killing the YouTube. Killing the YouTube. Let's see. That's see if you can buy them here on his YouTube. No. Where am I at here? Hoffman International. That's right. He's internationally known because he's known to rock the microphone. These ones right here, apparently you can't look at them unless you're old. Whoa, $105. I'm going to do it, man. Avert your eyes, people. Oh, it's another painting.
Oh,
$105. Check that out.
Yeah.
Let's go to it. I got to look at it. Got to open it up big time. And, oh, I like this one a lot.
Yeah.
Damn, cool. This one's nice. Man, if I had money right now, I'd be bidding on this motherfucker.
It's pretty cool.
Put that in my bathroom.
It's like the only place your wife will let you put them.
No, man, I got a bunch in my living room.
Yeah,
all your paintings, missing paintings from a few other people, and they're all in the living room. Yeah, that's like
cool.
I love it. Damn you, Mike! Damn you! $105, man. 2 days. I can't get a bid on this. Just sink the bank account tomorrow on this painting.
We gotta launch that fucking campaign today.
Yeah, so I can get the money to buy this. My wife would be fucking pissed. I'm gonna contact this.
That one will probably go up to you with a naked chick on.
Yeah, man, hold on, I got a bid on this one.
You're bidding on this one right now?
Shut up! No, I'm not bidding right now. I'm gonna watch it though. I'm gonna watch that one. That's the one I want.
Oh yeah.
I know, that's awesome. They know that one's awesome.
That's cool.
Hell yeah, man. Get that. Makes you paint, dude. It keeps me painting. It's like I'll stop painting and thinking like, oh, I just don't think I'm going to paint. And then see something like that. I was like, nope, back to painting.
Yeah, it's inspiring.
So what time we got? Well, we hit the 2 hour mark, and we did 20 minutes behind the scenes and just talked to ourselves and didn't even know.
Yeah.
So we want to go ahead and say good night. We can just call it for the night.
All right.
Sound good? Landon. Night, Landon. Thanks for being the one who showed up.
Yeah. We appreciate it.
There you go. And there were other people here. All right. That's it, though. I mean, I ain't ending with nothing fancy tonight. We just out.
See you guys.
Later.